Hey, here's another tricky quiz for you. What U.S. states were created from other states, or, on the other hand, denied admission? We'll go through the others later. Well, after the original 13 colonies became states, the United States, if you will, Vermont was created out of New York. You know, those mountain men. And Maine was actually the part of Massachusetts, even though not physically contiguous. Of course, after the Civil War, West Virginia seceded, so to speak, from Virginia, only because the Southerners weren't part of Congress at the time. On the other hand, some states sought admission and were denied on the first try. Tennessee sought admission as the state of Franklin. And Utah sought admission as the state of Deseret. By the way, California was the first state to be admitted that was non-contiguous with the other states. Anybody who's interested in military history will sometimes see those maps and the flags, and sometimes it'll just drive me crazy when the flag is inappropriate for the time period. And this is kind of a backward question. What participant flags were the same from the First World War, then called just the Great War, to World War II? And the obvious ones are certainly the German flag changed, the Italian fascist flag, the Japanese flag. Let's see. You know which one didn't change? The U.S. flag, which was 48 stars in both time periods, being almost brand new with the admission of Oklahoma, Arizona, and New Mexico just prior to the start of World War I. And you might say, what about the Canadian flag? And I don't mean the maple leaf flag, which was adopted way after World War II, but the flag for Canada during World War I made reference to the provinces, which have since increased, and in the 20s was changed to the origin of the peoples, the Irish, the Scots, the English, the French, and so on. And of course, the Russian flag was very different during World War I as opposed to the Soviet flag in World War II, and the Austro-Hungarian Empire was literally depicted upon their flag as such. Okay, time for question number three. What radio TV stations are on the wrong side of the Mississippi River, meaning the W's are in the west where they're normally in the east, and the K's are in the east when they're normally in the west? The list is actually quite exhaustive, but I'll show you some of the biggies. At the beginning of radio broadcast, it was a free-for-all, overlapping frequencies, whatever. And stations were given, when they started to organize this stuff, letters and numbers, provisionally. And the old ones had three letters. And the first station commercially was KDKA Pittsburgh. And the three-letter stations, you know, like you see, there's two of them there in Pennsylvania. You got WHO in Iowa. A whole slew of them in the west. And typically the W's, well, you'll see them normally should be on the right side of this map to the east, but there's exceptions here, and vice versa. And along the Mississippi River itself, there's a lot of exceptions. Okay, time for a bonus question. We can do this one of two ways. The Jackie Gleason show, The Honeymooners, was on what television network? And could be also worded, what was the first television network? And people will give me all the standard answers. Yes, there was a NBC Red and Blue that became ABC and CBS. No. It was the Dumont. And here's a map of those stations. You'll in fact see the letters for the New York affiliate. Then was the name of the initials of the founder, Dumont, now Channel 5. And on the West Coast, you had, well, it first aired on the then Channel 2, and then Channel 9 on the Dumont. While with the advent of HD TV, now going on its second decade, the original UHF and VHF stations, the format's no longer in use. There were seven stations in Los Angeles, like New York. Smaller markets had fewer. And then along came a couple of UHF stations, those above Channel 13. And the first one in Los Angeles was Channel 5, and started off with an experimental license, and likewise the case for Channel 2. And, well, let's see. Channel 2 started off as KTSL, call letters coming from Don Lee and original broadcaster's son's initials. The original CBS outlet was Channel 11, the call sign coming from its associated with the LA Times, Times TV. Letters were changed and associated with KNX, KNXT for television. By the way, there used to be a rule that the TV and radio stations having the same call had to be in the same city. That's no longer the case. In the case of KCBS Radio, AM, that's in San Francisco, but the FM is in LA. KNBC 4 was originally KNBH, National Broadcasting Hollywood. Parent company at the time was RCA. That explains that. Channel 7 used to be KECA from Earl C. Anthony, who at the time owned KFI. Channel 9, KCAL, and again, the rule, there's a KCAL FM in Redlands, top 40 station, but has nothing to do with them, used to be KHJ. We did Channel 11, KCOP Copley Broadcasting, now part of Fox, was originally KLAC, which is still an AM station. There's a listing there of the UHF stations. And as long as we're at it, where did Top 40 Radio start? Well, it turns out a guy named Storrs, spelled with a Z, bemoaning the fact that television was now replacing radio, and he was searching for a new format. And there he was at a malt shop, and he saw the kids dancing to the newfangled rock and roll and playing song after song after song from the jukebox, and he goes, that's a great idea for a format. And sure enough, he started the first rock and roll station